Hey guys, it's your girl Jazmine Tate, and I'm back with another video, and I'm answering the question of, do you need to have your client pay a deposit for your cleaning service? Okay. If you guys watched the previous video, you guys saw me talk about the whole contract agreement. If you didn't, go back and catch that video. But while I was chatting, I was like, you know what? I should totally do a separate video about this topic because it kind of goes hand in hand, and I kind of get the same question asked a lot within the Facebook group and here. So the question is, do I need to have my client pay a deposit? And no, you do not. I know basically having them pay that deposit is like that security blanket, right? I mean, it's called a security deposit for a reason. It's supposed to give you some extra assurity that the client is going to continue with the service that they are asking for, that they are going to come up and show up and get the work done. And if at least they cancel, I've gotten something, okay? I understand that. But we do not need to ask them for a deposit. I encourage everybody to look in, research, do your due diligence, you know, the market comparisons, and I plan to offer a video on this soon, on different booking platforms to see which one you would work best with for your business, okay? The one that I am currently using and recommend and talk about and have training videos in the academy for is Booking Koala. I love this platform because it offers pre-authorizations hold. That is the secret. That right there, that little two-letter word is replacing the other two words of security deposit, okay? The pre-authorization hold will check for the funds to make sure that the funds are available. So that way, it's doing that pre-authorization hold right before the cleaning service has been rendered. So now you're able to know that they have the money. And if they don't have the funds in their account, then you will also get notified that pre-authorization hold was declined, that it did not go through. So then you can contact them and let them know, like, hey, yo, what you doing? Like, we're cleaning your home tomorrow. This payment's not gonna go through, right? And I mean, you're not gonna let them know like that, but you get my drift, okay? And then also of that safety blanket, then you have your cancellation policy. Okay. Your cancellation policy fee is whatever you set it to be. Most common is a $50. Thank you, Jace Avery. Bye, Jace Avery.
Bye.
Bye. Sorry, y'all. You know, y'all know, if y'all, this is the first time watching, y'all know it's bound to happen that Jace Avery will pop in here a time or two, okay? Now you made me lose my train. Okay, security deposit. No, cancellation policy. So your cancellation policy is whatever fee amount you want that to be, whether it's $25, $40, $50. The most common is $50. So if they do cancel within 24 hours or whatever you set that to be, the most common is 24 hours, okay? Then it'll charge them automatically that $50 fee because you already put their card on file, okay? The moment they book their service on your booking platform and they put on there what all they want, 3-bedroom, 2-bath, 1,500 square feet, deep clean with, you know, laundry and dishes, right? I want to leave a tip. I'm going to pay for parking because it's street parking, whatever, right? They fill out the whole booking form. I want it to be done on September 12th at 4 p.m. Okay. Like whatever it is, then they go down below and they put their card on file and then they save their booking. You have their card information on file. So if they cancel within 24 hours or whatever your policy is, you're able to have that cancellation fee charged. Okay. If you want to have a little disclaimer underneath, like, hey, if this service is canceled within 24 hours, then you're charged this amount. Or if you want to like have a little tool tip where they have to tap on it to see it, like if you want to publicly disclaim your cancellation policy, if you want to send them an email, right after the service has been booked, hey, thank you so much, Jimmy, for booking your service with you. We're excited to serve you on September 12th at 4 p.m. Your assigned cleaner is Angelina, and she's amazing, okay? If by chance you want to cancel this service, please do so before 24 hours. Otherwise, you will be charged a $50 cancellation fee. Okay, send that nice little email reminder, right? And then set it up to resend it like a week prior to their appointment or a day prior to their appointment, or maybe not a day, but you know, some time before. So that way, that takes care of your security blanket. So you're not having to be so stressed out about collecting that that deposit for the service, okay? So you guys got it? This is one of the most asked questions. Do I have to make my clients pay a deposit? And the answer is no. But what I'm saying is get you a booking system that'll put all those systems in place for you. So that way you will be covered and protected, okay? And if they cancel within 24 hours, it's totally fine. You put their information in an inner loop and you follow up with them and you market to them and you get them back into your company, okay? Simple as that. I know it may sound super simple and something like, yo, Jazz, stop saying that. But look, babe, it really is. I promise. Like, the more consistent you do these practices, the more easier and the more simpler it really will be, right? It's just a little bit different from maybe how you're used to doing things or how you think the best way of doing things is. But having your business set up this way automates it. It allows you to be able to grow your company because it doesn't always require you to be doing all the things of all the things, okay? All right, y'all. Until next time. See you guys later. Please like, share, subscribe, do all the things of all the things. And I appreciate y'all. Bye.